lovely Calimaris, this is Calimara here. Welcome back to another Yandere Simulator redesign slash rewrite video. Today, we are going to be tackling the second rival, Amai Odayaka. But before we get into it though, I want to thank you guys for helping me get to 20k. I never thought I would get this far this fast, and I've developed this fear that I would lose my trajectory if I don't keep up my posting schedule, but I also have university assignments that, in all honesty, take greater priority for me. So, I do apologize if I'm slowing down a little bit with my content production. But recently, something pretty crazy happened. If you're subscribed to me, then you already know, but if you don't know, Yandere Dev actually nabbed fanart of my Osana redesign by the incredible Xylers, speed paint link in the description, and posted it on his April 7th blog post. I just find it a bit ironic that I created the redesign to criticize him and he thinks, oh look, pretty fanart. And it's also kind of weird that the fan art wasn't meant for him. And I will explain this. Obviously, since it wasn't my artwork, he didn't credit me. But it's just weird that he took fan art literally titled Calimara's Osana that he also commented on, mind you, and was like, oh, for me? Don't mind if I do. The comment is hidden now, but you can still see the replies of people calling him out. It's just a strange violation, I guess, because it's like getting a present and then someone comes and takes the present and tells everyone it was a present that they got. And I personally just don't want any sort of clout or exposure from someone like Yandev, so even if he had asked to use my designs, I would have told him no. These redesigns were never meant to show support for Yandere Dev or Yandere Simulator. It's pure criticism on Yandev's lack of writing skill and ability to create compelling story/characters. And it's also to point out how bad the game's story and characters actually are, because I don't think enough people actually talk about that. And because I don't want to just complain for complaining's sake, I also offer my own thoughts on how it could be improved if he actually cared. But I did speak to Xylers directly about it and how they felt about Yandev using their artwork, and they also feel the same way I did. And they also didn't want any clout from the dev man, so I asked Cameron F305, who I've been in contact with for a while, to just take it down and replace it with something else. It's replaced now, and I didn't nab a screenshot of it when it was still featuring Xylers' artwork, but I did go on the Wayback Machine and managed to scrounge up some evidence to my story. Like, you could say, oh, maybe he didn't know it was a redesign, except for the fact that Cameron F305 has told me that he's been showing Yandev my designs and he's been actively deleting comments on his blog post telling him that it was my redesign while the artwork was still up and to at least credit me. So, take that as you will. But it's resolved now, okay? It was an issue, it's still kinda weird he did that, but it's not an issue anymore. So let's move on, we're all adults here. As usual, we are going to be going through our four goals, giving Amai a stronger visual theme and updating her look to the rest of the characters I've redesigned so far. Speaking strictly on design, Amai is a bit more distinctive than Osana, but only because she has more accessories. If you took away her baked goods and apron, she looks even more generic than Osana, so I want to fix that. You can sort of see from the way her eyes are drawn and the expression she has that she's meant to be a soft, caring, non-threatening character. Very waifu material, so I'm gonna take that and implement it even further. Second, we will expand a bit more on her personality and backstory to fit her visual story. Third, we're going to give her a stronger connection to Senpai. And finally, we're going to talk about how everything could be implemented. Amai's concept reminds me a lot of my OC Kirana, who is one of the main characters in my comic Amber Hills on Webtoon if you're interested. And because it's good to write what you know, I decided to lend her some of my sweet girl's features. As you guys might have noticed, Kirana is quite a curvy lady, and her design was intended to give off a soft, plush, huggable look, which I think would fit Amai's soft personality very well. So because of this, I gave her a bit of a heavier build. I think it would make her look softer and help her stand out a bit better against the rest of the rivals, and it's always good to represent different body shapes in media. From a more selfish perspective though, it's also an opportunity for me to experiment with different body types, and because I know it would piss Yandev off. I've had a bit more time to practice, figure out my style, and improve my shortcomings, and I feel like I've improved quite a bit. For her face, I decided to give her a rounder, chubbier face to make her look soft and cute. It's one of those faces that will virtually never age, and you would still want to pinch her cheeks even when she's 30. I gave Amai the eye shape I usually use for Kirana, which are essentially just large doe eyes that melt your heart like hot fudge. I also gave her a sweet little smile that communicates a more bashful and introverted personality. Basically, I want her visuals to communicate that she is a marshmallow. And because of this, I also wanted her hair to look airy and light, like swirls of whipped cream or chocolate mousse. I knew what I was going for in my head, but I wasn't quite sure how the implementation would look. I just started sketching and figured I'd add or reshape it as I go. Aesthetically, I think the original design does a pretty good job of showing that she's a cook slash baker with her little bandana and apron, and I actually like the design of her stockings because they look like mint candy canes. It's probably one of the few pattern designs that actually worked in favor of the character's motive, but because I'm omitting the apron in this design, I just figured it would be weird for her to wear the apron outside of cooking club. I still decided to change her stockings to include buttons like you would see on a chef's uniform, and I added a cross section later on to make it look more like a chef's tunic as well. Anyway, while I completed the rest of the illustration, I started to get major Cinderella slash cottagecore vibes from Amai, which I thought was fitting. And as I started lining her hair, I decided at the last minute that I'd give her some more cinnamon bun-esque curls that I was really happy with. And with that, I basically had her design down pat. For her personality, it's actually one of my favorite ones out of all the rivals, and to me personally, it makes the most sense for why she would be a threat. She's a sweet, kind, and caring girl who looks after other people, because she did comfort Senpai when he was feeling vulnerable in the actual game, which, in my opinion, Yanchan should have been the one doing that, but Amai has the great makings of a traditional housewife, which culturally is pretty highly valued in Japan. So in my version, that would mean she is someone who could possibly be a mother figure to Hanako as well, which would be a huge appeal to Taro since that's really what their family needs. So there really isn't anything I'd change about her personality other than backing it up with her design and backstory. So with that, let's get on to her backstory. First things first, I decided that Amai should be a year above Yanchan because she needs that time to get to know Senpai and develop feelings for him. So I knew early on that I need to give her a different uniform color. I decided to go with green to match her current aesthetic. Green isn't usually a color that I like, and I do end up shifting the hue a little bit at the end to make it more of a teal color, so don't stress too much about the current ugly one. And if you know me, I don't just design characters a certain way without intention behind them. And you're probably thinking, this is a Japanese girl, and Japan is pretty much well known to have one of the lowest average weights in the world. And you would be correct. However, that doesn't mean that Japanese women can't be overweight. There are a lot of factors that come into a person's weight, and a lot of it has to do with genetics and metabolic rates, which is something you can't change that also makes life unfairly harder for certain people. In Japan, there's also a huge stigma against overweight bodies that have caused serious body image issues and eating disorders in a lot of young people. There's a very prevalent and unhealthy obsession and unrealistic expectations of weight in Japan and other East Asian countries. Thus, I thought it would be good to give some representation to the small, oppressed minority of people who are a little bit heavier. But how does this impact my version of Amai? Naturally, because of the cultural stigma on weight in Japan, Amai was subjected to a lot of bullying. Kids made fun of her because of her weight and how she looks and made her very unconfident in herself. She exercises frequently and tries to eat a healthy diet, but she just can't seem to achieve the body that the rest of the girls in her classes have. It doesn't help that her parents run a bakery, which people have used to spread rumors that she eats all the leftover goods. Because of this, she's the kind of person who would often shy away from the spotlight and avoid attention. But she is also very empathetic of those around her who were also suffering because she understands how they feel. She does have a pair of loving parents who encourage her to follow her passion regardless of what anyone says, and she finds comfort in cooking. She's very skilled in it, in fact, and shortly after joining the cooking club, she was appointed their new leader. It helped her feel more confident with herself and bridged the gap between a lot of people who she had less than favorable interactions with in the past, and basically helped her find a place she belonged. As for her connection with Senpai, I think we can make it a bit stronger than just she meets him and falls in love. If you haven't seen my redesigning Senpai video already, I basically made Senpai the surrogate parent for Hanako because their mother is gone and their father is basically neglecting them. And because of this, Senpai had to learn to look after himself and his sister, and that includes doing the cooking in the house. I think at one point, Hanako's school, because in my headcanon she's much younger and goes to a different school, was holding a bake sale and they had to bring something from home to donate to the event, but Senpai doesn't know how to bake. That's where Amai comes in. Knowing that she's probably the most qualified person for the job, he asks her for her help to teach him how to bake. Of course, he asks her to keep it a secret. For him, it's because he doesn't want anyone possibly asking why he needs to learn to bake in the first place and finding out about his home situation, and for her, she probably thinks he's just embarrassed. Long story short, he starts hanging out with her after school when everyone has pretty much gone home so she can teach him how to make brownies. They form a friendship, and he discovers that she's being bullied, and because he hates bullies, he basically starts intimidating her bullies to stop. He knows that she's a sweet person, and because of that, he's quite protective of her. After all, she kept his secret and helped him out of a tough spot. And because of his protectiveness and surprisingly gentle nature, Amai falls in love with him. For implementation, it's not really explained why Amai was absent for the first week, even though it's a really easy fix. Just say she got permission to take a week off to participate in some baking competition. She comes back in the second week having won first place, and Yan-chan starts noticing her hanging around Senpai a lot and being too familiar with him. From there, she can do her investigative work to find out her history with Senpai and figure out the best method to eliminate her. If you befriended Osana, You can use her to help you gather information and figure out her plans to confess. Another advantage to befriending Osana is also that you earn her support, which would mean that she would be willing to discourage others from confessing to senpai, which is a huge advantage. Unlike Osana though, who was always going to be rejected by senpai, Amai's confession is the first one with the real possibility of being accepted. So you need all the resources you can get. Leading up to her confession, she will be giving senpai a lot of gifts which you as the player can sabotage to ruin her relationship and reputation with senpai, and you could even sabotage her cooking in general to destroy her confidence and make her decide not to confess anymore, or just outright murder her. But considering her close relationship with senpai, you're going to be making things a lot harder for yourself in the long run. Of course, the best route here is to befriend Amai and convince her not to confess to senpai. And because Amai is such a kind person, of course she would be understanding. If you do befriend her, Yanchan will learn the virtue of kindness and gain a better support mechanic for when her mental state begins to deteriorate later on in the game. Similar to Osana, Amai will also put in a good word for you to senpai, further encouraging him to be with you instead. This is also another step closer to the best ending, which I explained in my name reveal video where I also read some of your feedback for my ideas. So with all that being said, this is the final design. I really like how Amai turned out, and I definitely think she's my favorite one so far. Making these videos have really helped me improve my art skills, so I'm really thankful for that. I do want to try branching out and doing other things like animatics to expand the relationships for these redesigns and other series in general, and I hope you guys will stick around for that. But with that being said, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end and for sending me all this amazing fan art. While I was recording my speed paint, I actually forgot I had it set to record audio as well. So here is a phone conversation I had with my sister as a bonus for you who stayed to the end. Enjoy. I've been having nightmares of Lily Jean and her mom. Yeah, I've been having nightmares of like encountering Lily Jean and her mom. And like the weird thing is like I always sympathize with Lily Jean and I'm always arguing with her mom in my dreams. Which is super weird. And like most recently in my dream.
Yeah.
Hang on, I can't think. Yeah, recently I dreamt that I was at a hotel for something. Like, yeah. It was like an event or something. Like, I think we were on a family vacation because, like, you were there and mom and dad was also there. And hang on, I can't multitask. I'm too stupid for this. Yeah, we were on vacation. And then suddenly, like, Lily Jean's mom came and she was like, "Oh, we have to talk about your copyright infringements." And I'm like, okay. Okay, I guess. So we sat down to talk and she's like trying to make points, but I'm like, no, you're wrong. That's not how it works. And because like it's not how it works. Yeah. And I'm like trying to explain these things to her. And like at some point she just whispers to like one of her henchmen, like, "Get the rope." And I'm like, ah, no. So I ran. And I tried to run to my room and she was like chasing me and like literally I had so much adrenaline, like the adrenaline was so crazy. And like I ran to the room where you were in and like the door wouldn't close immediately because it was like one of those slow closing doors that prevented it from slamming. And I was like to you like, "Dude, help me close the door." Cause like she was coming.
The rope.
I know. I was like in my mind, I just like it gave me like kidnapper vibes, like she's gonna abduct me and keep me in her basement.
Exactly.